things. Some of this stuff over today before it rains. Some of this chop and drop, recent chop and drop, is yet to be chopped. And I thinned out my, actually I pretty much took out my morning glory here. It was, we still got a little bit going here maybe left, but I might make a comeback if we get some rain here. It'll probably come right back. But it was getting a little it was getting a little ugly looking. So I took it out right here. It wasn't doing what I thought it was going to do. Well, it did actually. It made a lot of nitrogen-rich fertilizer for my chop and drop. That's actually with the purpose of what I wanted to have. It's good to have vines because that's more. The more stuff you grow, more stuff you can put down to feed the soil. during the dry season. Florida, we don't really have much of a dry season, but we do get a little few dry spells every now and again. Got some dragonflies. Got a couple clouds out there. Looks like we might get some rain. We got this orange tree we share with the neighbor here. It's about 15, 20 years old. There's an elderberry tree. I cut it back about right here. And see where I cut it back right here. Then it started growing again. And now it's about as tall as right here. Here. And try to keep it short bushes. Make it into an elderberry bush. Got another one here. Because they can get to be pretty big. Got some of this stuff here. This is wavy leaf basket grass right here. The seeds get, when they bloom, they get sticky, and they're about to bloom right now. As you can see, these are going to bloom, and it's going to get real sticky. And it'll get all over your slippers. They're not really blooming yet. I'm going to try to mow it. The stuff is better than, it's sort of a better than grass alternative for me. It's been acting as kind of like a living compost instead of having to chop and drop on everywhere. I don't want weeds to grow. This is kind of working out pretty good. I'm trying to get it so I get it basically so that we either have dichondra or this or low-lying ground covers that don't really need to be mowed. I'm trying to get away from the use of gasoline. And also, this garden is completely organic. There's no no use of anything artificial, everything is chop and drop and get back to the earth. I don't, a lot of the material that people just throw out in the yard, like these palm fronds, they'll cut them back, put them out front, and the city will take them for free, of course, because they use it for their landfill to cover up the all the things that they, all the trash that will have to eventually be dealt with another way. I noticed a lot of those landfills, they are an extravagant waste of resources. So they burn off a lot of their methane gas just burn it off. They have actually a flame going over at Lena. I went over to Lena and checked it out. It's a pretty filthy operation, you know. So it does help them out. They it helps the city out for you to be giving them your debris. But it doesn't necessarily help your garden out. So that is why chop and drop is the way to go, folks. Even before I heard the term, was doing it with grass clippings. This whole garden started with just some grass clippings, and started killing off some of the grass. There was really no shade to speak of, and I even used some of these the fruit. There's some really sweet fruit up in here in this palm. If you can see up in here, it's sorry, I haven't been really looking into the camera. I'm just kind of, I didn't zoom in very too well. Hopefully it's not making you dizzy. Might stay. Sometimes I hit stabilize, but I think that might mess with make it blurry. Might mess with the quality. So it's just a camera phone. This isn't a very fancy phone, camera, but it gets LG does get pretty good. I did buy this phone because it does have a pretty good camera. It's LG. I had an LG before, and I'm not trying to do an advertisement for LG unless they want to pay me. And I would be glad to do so. And I thank all of you who watch this channel. Listen to that. It's a jungle out there. These squirrels, you'll see the squirrels jumping around from these limbs. Be nice. I got them one. You gotta be quick with the camera to get them in action. But I did see one jump. I had one in my videos. I've slowed it down, and you can kind of see a blurry squirrel jumping like full Superman jump. Look at that moringa blooming like crazy, providing all kind of shade and places for birds to perch. Some of those, I hadn't quite decided what I want to do. I need to start thinking about trimming this thing up a little bit. But you gotta admire the way. I just want to take a minute to admire this thing before I do that, because I am getting to be good time to start harvesting a lot of this stuff. I have some seeds. I got a lot of seeds on the trees that I need to put them in, make sure they're dry, put them in jars. So if you're in Bradenton, come on down and get you some moringa seeds for free. On Big Nick. No questions asked. Here, let's what did I just see here? We got a some sort of lizard. That's what we got here. I knew I saw some. See, I'm not blind. These guys are pretty entertaining. This little boxwood is starting to shape up pretty nice. I took the machete over the top right here and making a nice little, adding some directionality to my pathways. And all the plants you see here are for sale as well. If you're watching this video, you're in Bradenton. Buku cuttings by donation. Come on down, bring you a bucket. I'll give you some cuttings of all kind of stuff. These cherry trees do really well by cuttings. These are also Surinam cherry. They little bit bitter. They can be a little bitter, but if you give them the right nutrients, they can get give them the right when they're good and ripe and sweet, they're good. They're not bitter. They're very good. I sit here and eat like 20 or 30 of them, and that'll be my breakfast. They got a lot of vitamin C, vitamin potassium, more potassium than bananas. I was looking at the nutrition facts on these things. They got buku potassium, as does the starfruit. We got a baby starfruit here coming up, and I got a whole bunch of these starfruits now in different stages of progress. Most of them started in a pot and I transplanted them, and this is Eastern leopard grasshopper, by the way, folks. He's on my mango tree. This bonsai mango tree. He's not really damaging anything. I find they add a lot of character to the gardens. They're very interesting. They usually will try to fly out of your way. They're not aggressive at all. They seem to be pretty smart. And they're very beautiful, if you ask me. A lot of people say you smash and burn them and do all kinds of cruel and unusual stuff, and I don't really know quite why, but it's usually whatever. When I see people doing something one way, I try to find my own way. Here we got, I went ahead and topped off this banana plant right here. It looks kind of hacked up. Got a brand new leaf. I got just barely tipped part of the leaf when I cut it. And then we got the new growth coming straight through the middle. I just wanted to let some of the sun shine in because I wanted to clear out some places where I'm going to start clearing out some beds again. I kind of let things run wild a little bit and grow, and it's getting time to start cutting back. Sometimes it looks like you're cutting back too much, but out here in Florida, it's wet and you don't want things getting soggy, moldy. You want the circulation to flow. So I just cut a big branch out of this Suriname cherry here, and I'm gonna go ahead and top it off. All this stuff you're looking at right here will be part of chop and drop material, for the most part. Well, actually, some of the lower branch, I'm probably gonna get some of these lower branches and maybe do it a little at a time. But I just want to point out something with these. Let's see if I can see on here. See if I can see. Well, you can see it split off here. Anytime you see it split off, ooh, it splits off again. So you go further down, and what you do is they call it tipping. You just pick any spot, tip it, pull it off with your fingers. It's easier to do it on the tips where it's nice and fresh. And when you do that, you discourage it from getting long and lanky, and you encourage all the energy to focus its energy on these other branches that are pointing straight up more toward the sun. So you want to keep that kind of stuff in mind when you're pruning your tree, where the how the they say you should prune it so that you can have a bird fly through. And I think that was the best way I heard it put. When I heard it put like that, I try to imagine a bird easily being able to locate a place to land, but still have some privacy, even, you know, not too, you don't want to make anything too stark unless you're about to have a rain. You know, it's going to be rainy and you got a real vigorous. Sometimes you can actually get a little carried away cutting things back. Like I had a banana plant that I actually cut the flower off, and cost myself probably about 30 bananas. That would have ended up being a big banana stalk. But as soon as I cut the flower, the plant started dying, and I learned a big lesson. And if I would have just looked more carefully, I would have noticed that the flag leaf was coming through the center of the banana plant, and you get it, and it was, you could actually see part of the flower coming out. And I just was a little hasty. This stuff right here, cosmos, looks like a weed, but it's a nice orange flower. You can It's really holds a lot of water in these stems. It's just pretty much 99% water, and crushes up, and it's used for Chinese medicine. I'm not sure. I think it's how it's used. I mean, also, this is a lot of things are Chinese medicine. This monkey grass right here, or spider grass, as well as this basket plant right here. They all hold lots of water when it gets dry. They can stand the sun, and that is why you will see them throughout the garden. Peace garden of everlasting tranquility and purple love. And it's grown quite into something jungle-esque. Here, this star fruit, I've been pruning it. They say you don't really need to prune star fruit, but I ignored that kind of advice on this one, as you can see, and I've totally ignored it on this one. This one is what you would consider a hack job, just bare. I cut it bare, but I was trying to be conscientious of this tree here that was getting blocked out completely. It looks like it's on its last leg. I'm gonna cut all this back, and I cut this way back. It's gonna be a nice frangipani, or it's a Hawaiian flower. So we got another one of these guys here. He's on the cordyline, and it's got a nice purple color. And those guys are just, see, they all look a little different too if you look at them. It's interesting, kind of interesting. Like this one has kind of some black on them. And they start out black and yellow, looking like Steeler fans. And then they start looking like the Green Bay Packers. And then apparently they turn into this later on. This guy looks like an old, like he's been around a leaf or two. He's keeping an eye out on this lemon tree here. Hopefully he'll eat some of those Asian moths, caterpillars. I've seen them on my Myers lemon tree. Got three little puny lemons on it right now, and it's been really dry. Check this out. How dry all that stuff is. I just put this on today. Got this basket plant right here. This is all pure water. I can basically run that all over with the mower. This is basically a drainage easement right here. And this bamboo is good for easements. It grows well in easements. So when I had the rainy season, I just stuck this in the ground and from another place where it had gotten overgrown. Most of these plants started from one plant or two plants, and I just continued to spread them around. And we got a raspberry bush that is kind of died back. I cut it back a little bit, quite a bit, and looks like it's basically, I had it going through here, through there, all the way through there. Ooh. Butterfly. Had it going all the way up through here. And it's basically has gone past. I need to get some gloves on before I trim that. And kind of feel something down here. Yeah, something here. You never know what it could. Got some, I saw a couple different kind of snakes out here. Nothing poisonous, nothing to be worried about. Just all part of the circle of life. Be cool to get one. On camera, I've been working at this tree today a little bit, and wait a minute, I need to probably make this video shorter, but it's turning into a long video. This one, I hadn't really gotten a video in a while of everything at once since, look at these leaves on this avocado tree, it's ridiculous or what? What have I done to deserve these huge leaves? Like this thing, you would think I was giving it just, you know what it is? I think I used to bury a bunch of fruit here, and I think that it just fed and fed and fed this area. Plus all this, look at all this chop and drop down here. I got a cactus actually growing. This is actually a dragon fruit, type of a dragon fruit kind of a thing, cactus. It's kind of weird.